So the next question we have is about an advanced patient, and I guess the doctor wants to put him on Xgeva. He wants to know, would you just put him on Xgeva? Obviously, we don't know the case history of it, but how effective have you seen Xgeva in advanced prostate cancer?
So Xgeva is FDA approved for men that have bone metastasis. It's been shown to cut the risk of bone-related complications from cancer when men are given Xgeva. There's also one study showing that in men who have prostate cancer that get Xgeva, that it will delay the growth of cancer in the bone to some degree, not dramatically, but to a measurable degree. Offsetting all those positives, there is an issue related to something called osteonecrosis, where there's damage to the jaw caused by large doses of these medications given over a prolonged period of time. So there's probably a happy medium. The Xgeva is FDA approved for monthly administration, and that dose might be a little high. It seems that the incidence of osteonecrosis is fairly frequent when full doses are used for prolonged periods of time. And so, but we do know that there are benefits from these medicines. So some sort of compromise, maybe treatment administered every 3 months, every 6 months, seems to be a nice in-between ground to consider to balance out the risks and the benefits of Xgeva.
What would the PSA monitoring look like for that?
So Xgeva, to my knowledge, doesn't have any impact on PSA. It doesn't. It does strengthen the bones. So, like some other medicines that are available for treating osteoporosis, Xgeva helps bring more calcium into the bones and fortifies them. But it doesn't lower PSA or raise PSA, for that matter.
So the next question we have is, which side effects of ADT are more prevalent for different durations of treatment, and ADT being androgen deprivation therapy or hormone therapy? So are there side effects that are more prevalent in the 6 month dose versus the 24 month dose?
Right. So intermediate risk patients get 6 months of testosterone deprivation, and high risk patients, Gleason 9s, 10s, PSAs over 20, get 18 months of testosterone deprivation. The cumulative effect of low testosterone probably is most pronounced in muscle loss and weight gain. Those are the most prominent issues, and we've emphasized over and over that men need to do a resistance training program, be on a careful diet while they have a low testosterone to offset those problems.
I know I was talking to a couple patients recently, and I had heard a similar storyline, that they were on hormone therapy for about 6 months and they never experienced any hot flashes or anything of that sort. They did experience the fatigue. So is that normal that you see patients who are on the 6 month version of hormone therapy not have as many symptoms as far as hot flashes and things like that go? Or is that just dependent on the person?
Completely dependent on the person. People could have hot flashes, within 3 or 4 weeks of starting treatment, or they may not get them at all.
So this person says that their dad was diagnosed with prostate cancer and they did find bone mets, and that they started him on Xtandi and Orgovyx, which was recently approved. They said that their dad's PSA was 94 and then 200 1 week before it spiked to 200 1 week before he started these medications. This person would like to know, why wasn't chemo or surgery an option for their father, and why did they just put him on these medications instead?
Well, that's a very broad question. There are certainly situations where Taxotere chemotherapy would be a logical consideration. The studies so far haven't looked at the combination of Xtandi plus Orgovyx or Lupron plus chemotherapy. So the benefits of chemotherapy in this situation are theoretical, and I think the theoretical foundation is pretty strong, but there's no studies yet proving that you should do Taxotere in that situation. The other aspect of the question about giving radiation, that is, there are two types of radiation. One would be to try and radiate any spots of cancer, and that might be a consideration if there were just two or three spots. When people have multiple spots around their body, it's not practical to radiate all those spots. But another area of research is to radiate the main tumor in the prostate, and there are some preliminary studies suggesting that that might be advantageous, controversial, however. So these are sensible questions, and this individual might want to get a second opinion and talk to some different experts about the feasibility of some of these things, but there's certainly situations where the Xtandi plus the Orgovyx alone would be quite appropriate.
So this person is asking that, you know, they, a lot of people believe that testosterone feeds cancer. And so they're wondering why younger men who have higher testosterone, you know, in their bodies don't, you know, get it younger or die sooner because of it.
Right. That is actually somewhat of a fallacy. While removal of testosterone can cause prostate cancer to regress, the presence of testosterone in normal males is not the cause of prostate cancer. The cause of prostate cancer is uncertain. It may have to do with inflammation. It may have to do with genetic predispositions or other factors that we're not clear about. But the idea that testosterone is causing the cancer is incorrect. So the best analogy I've come up with, and it may not be a very good one, is the way we all need oxygen to exist. But if you give us more oxygen, we don't live longer, we don't live more vibrantly, we continue to exist. But if you take our oxygen away, we die. So prostate cancer cells depend on testosterone just the way we depend on oxygen to live. But having oxygen did not create our life or cause our life. Oxygen is necessary to exist, but it doesn't engender life itself. Neither does testosterone generate cancer.
Hi everyone, it's Alex and Hunter. Hunter's our official PCRI mascot. If you'd like to learn more about men's health tips and prostate cancer, you can follow him on Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel. We come out with new prostate cancer videos every week. Say bye!